My name is Linda Fisher. I live in Denton, Texas, and I was diagnosed with breast cancer in September of 2004 and went through chemo and radiation 2004-2005, and then was put on hormone therapy for 6 years. At the 5-year mark, I started having a lot of pain in the bones. They did a biopsy on T5 on my spine, and then they ran another biopsy on my ilium because I had a lot of pain in my leg and in my hip. And I said, if you're going to check this spot on my back, you need to check my leg and my hip. They did discover breast cancer in my bone in March of 2010, and I started on Aridia at that time. Also, breast cancer went to the liver, and that's my biggest battle now. And they started me on an oral, very expensive medicine, made me sick both rounds. So my doctor was going to take me off, and I let him know that I'd already bought that medicine and that maybe my body had adjusted to it, and maybe we need to try it one more time. So we tried, and I started throwing up again, so he took me off and put me on a different regimen. You have to make sure that as a cancer patient, they have to look at more than just one test. They can't go on a tumor marker. They need to look at scans. They need to look at x-rays. They need to look at many things to determine what kind of treatment they need to keep you going. The thing that is so nice is that medicine has advanced so vast and great in the past years that cancer patients are living longer and longer, and this is a good thing. I did have my tumor markers that ran 200 to 400, which is high, normal's 38. Mine ran 400 until December of 2013. They jumped up to 1,500 number. By the end of the month, they were 2,611, and by January, they were 3,211. So they took me off of all treatment. Because I've been battling this for such a long time, my oncologist thought that I had exhausted all hormones because I'm estrogen positive, but we got to look and he looked at me and said, you've never had tamoxifen. And I said, you know, I haven't. So he started me on tamoxifen, waiting on biopsy results to come back from the liver. He was checking for antigen receptors because if you're positive for antigen receptors, that can open up a whole other field for treatment that they can give you, which I was positive, and that is good. In April, my tumor markers came down to 600 count and have come down 5 times since then and are now sitting at 176, although that's still high. That's lower than they've ever been in the last 4 years. I do want to stress that as a cancer patient, you need to ask questions. You need to talk with other people. You need to talk with your doctor of what options are out there for you that maybe they haven't discussed with you. If you find out information on anything related to cancer, make sure you check with your doctor to see if that's something that would benefit your particular treatment. And every treatment is looked at differently because every person's different. But I just want everyone to know that we are striving for more and more birthdays. In January of 2012, we were fortunate enough in Denton to have a yoga class for cancer patients. And we have two teachers, Pam and Susan, that started Yoga Bridge, and I have been taking yoga with them weekly. I'm so glad that we have this opportunity. The thing that's wonderful about Yoga Bridge, it's specifically for cancer patients. So look up www.yogabridge.org. Yes to hope.